Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at how the photo app works in iOS 7. So when you upgrade to iOS 7, you may have noticed that the Photos app looks a little different. The way you enter into it and find photos is a whole new method. So let's take a closer look. So when you first go into the Photos app, you may see it like this. Now it always remembers where you were the last time, so you may be in a different spot. For instance, if you're looking at your albums, it will return you to your albums. And if you've already dug into the different years here, it will return you to that spot. But you can always go back by hitting a button in the upper left that we'll see in a second. Here you can see I've got synced from my Mac, from iPhoto, I have photos covering three different years. And you can see how it breaks them up by showing me these little thumbnails and also showing me a title that gives me some locations that these photos were taken. Now I can tap on the screen inside these little photos, and if I tap and hold I can actually see larger views of the photos there. And I can scroll my finger over and I can get an idea of what photos are there. And I can easily just move my finger up and put it over any thumbnail to see the photos. Now if I release my finger over a thumbnail, it will jump right to that photo. So a quick way to get right from this top level view all the way down into photos. But if you want to dig down just one level, you can tap on the group of thumbnails. Say I'm going to do it for 2013 right here. Tap on it and it will dig down into that 1 year. And this is called a collection. You can see the top collections. So I have collections inside of that year. And I can use the years button at the top left to return to years and tap to go into a collection. So now the thumbnails are a little bigger, and I can still do the same basic thing. I can tap and hold over a specific photo and you can see it will enlarge it slightly. And I can jump to right into one photo. Or I could tap in the entire collection and dig down into that. Now I can see the individual photos even larger, and to jump up into the collections I can hit the button at the upper left. Now they're broken further into things called moments, and these are even smaller areas of time, often just one day. And if I tap on a photo in one of these moments, I'll jump right to that photo. Let's go all the way back up to years. Another thing I can do with years is instead of tapping on the photos themselves, the little thumbnails, I can tap on the title. So let me do that for 2013. I'll tap on the title there and it's going to jump to a map view, and it's going to show me my photos on a map in different groups. So you can see it's grouped them into three areas of the world. I can tap on an area and it will jump down and show me those photos, and I can go back by tapping on the upper left. And I can go all the way back up to years as well. You can do the same thing in smaller pieces. So I can jump into 2013 here, and then I can go to one section here, this one, and I can tap on the top there where it has a location where it says London, England. I can tap in and it will give me a map right there, where as you can see it's much closer in because it's all photos taken within a short period of time. And I can then dig down into these smaller areas here to see those photos. Now you don't have to use this system. If you like how it worked before, you can still do that. You see at the bottom of the screen it has photos and albums. I can jump over to albums and there's all my photos arranged by the different albums, including the camera roll album, and it even gives you all your videos in one specific album there. That's stuff taken on your iPad or on your iPhone in the camera roll there. And then you see the albums, three of them that I've synced from my Mac from iPhoto, and you can sync from PC as well. You do the syncing through iTunes, but the arrangement of those groups was done in iPhoto. Now of course I can also edit this group here, and I could add my own album in here. So I can create an album here on the iPad or iPhone if I want. And I can dig down into these albums just as I could before, and it just shows me all the photos in the album. So this is kind of how it worked before. The functionality here of having this photos view with years and then collections and then moments is what's new. Now the whole point here is to give you a way to easily find your photos without having to arrange them in albums. If you like arranging all your photos in albums so you can find them easily, you can still use that. But if you don't have the time for that, if you just have all your photos in iPhoto, you sync them all to your iPad or iPhone, and you want to find that vacation photo from last year when you're on the beach in Maui, you can quickly dig down into the year, look at the map, Find Maui, find that photo. And also it's great for those people that don't use the syncing back and forth very much. They simply just take pictures on their iPhone and they leave them on the iPhone. Then when you have a variety of pictures, hundreds of them taken over the last couple of years, you can use this system to quickly find those photos because it combines everything from stuff that you've synced from your Mac or PC and photos in your camera roll. So I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.